Okay, dear students, welcome to 15th lesson. This is the 15th lesson that we are going to discuss. In 14th lesson, what we have discussed? Contract with a miner. In this lesson, what we have already discussed in the 14th lesson is whether the ratification is possible with a miner's contract or not, whether the restitution or restoration is possible with the miner's contract or not, what if a miner willingly misrepresents his age of his age and enters into the contract or insists the others to enter into the contract. All these things what we have already discussed. Now what we are going to discuss with you is, what is the liability of a minor in a tort? What is the liability of a minor in a tort? Now, let me see, what is the minor's liability? Minor's liability in a tort. What do you mean by the tort? Civil wrong. Let me first explain you what do you mean by the civil wrong. Civil wrong means in case of the mistake of the minor or negligency of the minor, any financial loss is caused to the other party, that amounts to a civil wrong or a tort on the part of the minor. Now, we have to fix the minor's liability in a tort. Good. If in a tort, minor is authorized, minor acted within his authority, minor acted beyond his authority. Minor acted within his authority, minor acted beyond his authority. I will take simple examples regarding this. A minor, I will represent him with MI. He borrowed or he hired a horse for the riding purposes. Now, he is the horse owner. Now, minor, while using this horse, behaved negligently, and the horse is died off. Negligently behaved means what? He behaved, that means he used for the riding purposes, but negligently he used, the miner used over and above hours of riding, thereby horse died off. Now, miner is liable or not? Now I am asking you a question. Whether the miner is authorized to use the horse for the riding purposes or not? Yes, he is authorized. Why? He hired the horse only for the riding purposes. Hence, he is authorized to ride the horse, or he authorized to use the horse for the riding purposes, and he used it for the same, but negligently behaved, thereby some financial loss is occurred to the horse owner. Now there is no liability on the part of miner. Now, for example, in the same example, miner hired the horse for the riding purposes, but he had given it to his friend, one of his friends, and his friend used for the racing purposes, thereby the horse died off. Now, this is the miner. Miner handed over the horse to his friend. and friend used for it for the racing purposes, and now the horses died off. Whether miner is liable in this case or not? Let me ask you same question. For which purposes miner hired the horse? For the riding purposes. By own purpose, that too. He has to ride himself. But what he done? This miner had given the horse to his friend. Friend used it for the racing purposes. Whether he is used for the authority or within the authority or beyond his authority, he acted beyond his authority. Thereby, financial loss occurred to the horse owner. Hence, this can be recovered from the miner's estate. Bear in mind, from the miner's estate. But miner still is not personally liable, even though if it is a tort. Even though for it, if it is a tort, miner is not at all liable. Good. Miner's liability in case of a borrowed funds. Liability in case of a borrowed money. Whether minor is liable or not. The court, the law says that lender can recover. Lender can recover if the money borrowed is available in spurs. What is the meaning of money borrowed available in spurs to the lender? That means, let me take and explain you a simple example. Here what happened. A miner, I am representing the miner with M, borrowed rupees 10,000, lender given 2,000 denominations, and the miner went to home. Thereafter, lender find out that he lent money to a miner. Immediately, lender visited the home of or the house of the miner. He find out the 10,000 rupees in the house of the miner. But the 10,000 is either they are 5,000 denominations or 100 denominations or 200 denominations, whatever it may be. Because that money the miner's father had brought from outside for the household purposes and he kept in house, and that money had been traced or find out by the money lender. Whether the money lender is authorized to recover the said 10,000 rupees or not, he is not authorized. He is not allowed. Why, sir? That is the meaning of available in spice. That means the same money which he lent to the miner, if he finds out the same money, then only he is eligible or allowed to recover. Here what happened? The money what he lent to miner is not available in the house of miner. Which money is available? The money borrowed by his father for the household purposes had been recovered by the lender. Hence, he is not supposed to recover that money. That is the example. Next. Sir, what if miner uses to purchase an asset with the borrowed money? Whether an asset may be a movable asset or may be an immovable asset, irrespective whether it is a movable asset or immovable asset, what if the miner uses the same money for the purposes of purchase of any asset? Now, let me take a simple example. Miner borrowed 20,000 rupees and he used it to purchase a bike with that, whether this bike is recoverable by the money lender or not? Yes, can recover. Can recover. Now, let me summarize the liability of a minor in case of the torts. Tort means nothing but a civil wrong. Civil wrong is nothing but in case of a person gets any financial loss due to the negligency or negligent behavior of a minor, whether the minor is whether we can place the liability upon the minor or not. Law says that in case if minor is authorized to do something and doing it in negligent way, thereby someone caused a financial loss, such a loss is not liable on the part of the minor. In case if the minor is not unauthorized, in the previous example what we have seen is the minor had taken the horse for the riding purposes on his own, but he gave it to his friend and the friend used it for the racing purposes, thereby minor is liable. What if minor is borrowing money? If the borrowed money is available to the lender in spice, that means the same money what he lent, he can recover. If the minor utilizes the same money for the purposes of acquisition of any property, whether it is a mobile property or immobile property, the money lender can recover the same. Then you may ask me a question. Sir, what do you mean by necessary first of all? As far as the economics definition is concerned, necessary means supply of food, clothing, shelter to anybody will be termed or treated as a necessary. But in the legal context, the definition of necessary is varied, different. Here, there is no standard list of necessaries. No standard list. Law says, it is to fix whether it is the necessary at the time of supply by a person to a minor or not, as per the case, circumstances, situation of each and every separate case. In a reputed case, a cloth merchant had supplied 10 pairs of cloth, 10 pairs of cloth to a minor girl. At that point of time, the minor girl is having plenty pairs of cloths with her. She is already having 20 pairs of cloths. That means, even though as far as the economics necessary is concerned, the economics definition necessary is concerned, cloths form part of the necessities. As far as the legal or law context is concerned, we have to examine case by case whether the things supplied by a person to a minor is necessary or not. Now let me examine, or let me ask you one thing, whether it is necessary at the time of supply when the girl is already having 20 pairs of cloths? Absolutely no. In such a case, even though the supply of cloth will not be treated as a necessary. Now, in another case, a minor is having his grandson, grandfather, and grandfather and grandson is only the family members. No one is there with them, and unfortunately, the grandfather had died off. At that point of time, for the burial, funeral purposes, minor is not having money in the hands. He borrowed money at that point of time from a money lender in the village. Now, even though as far as economics definition of necessities are concerned, money, gold will not be covered. But as far as the situation of the scene is concerned, the circumstance is concerned, at that point of time, money for the funeral purposes, funeral expenses is very important to a minor. Hence, money at this point of time is necessary. For example, if a money lender or if a shopkeeper lent grocery for the household, who is the miner, whether it is a necessary or not. Yes, it is a necessary. If a money lender lent money for the purpose of purchase of academic books, payment of fees, even though it is a money, whether it is necessary or not. Yes, it is a necessary. Hence, whether the miner is liable for the necessaries or not. Miner is not personally liable, but his estate is liable. Miner in this case is not personally liable, but his estate is liable. Now you may ask me a question, sir, what is the main difference in between he is not personally liable and estate is liable? We cannot fix personal liability on the part of minor. For example, minor had been supplied necessities, grocery by a person, and on the failure of the repayment of the money by the minor, money lender had taken off all the assets, all the estate, all the property of minor, and he recovered. But he recovered to the extent of 70% of the debt. For the remaining 30%, because of he supplied necessities, now he is asking the miner to render the miner's services or to work with his shop, in his shop, for the set off of remaining 30% of his debt, which he is not recovered from the estate of the miner, which is not available, which is not allowed to a shopkeeper. What happened here? Miner borrowed some money, or a shop owner supplied groceries to the miner. Yes, it is a necessary. But the miner failed to repay the money. The shop owner had totally captured the total property of the miner. Yes, his estate is liable. He captured total assets. But on realization of the total assets, 70% of his debt only set off. For the remaining 30%, shop owner is asking the miner to render, to work in his shop to set off this 30,000 rupees or 30% of liability, which is not allowed. That is the meaning of miner is not personally liable, but his estate is liable, his property is liable. Now the question is, can a miner be a partner in a partnership firm? Can a miner be a partner in a partnership firm? Now, say for example, partnership also is nothing but an agreement. This agreement will be done by a deed, which will be treated as a partnership deed. A partnership deed is nothing but an agreement. Agreement in between the partners or among the partners if there are more than two partners. Very good. Now, as far as the minor is concerned, minor's status is concerned, because of the minor, he is not allowed to be a contracting party. He is not allowed to enter into the contract with the other partners unequal, at par situations, at par grounds. But law is silent. Law is not prohibiting a minor to admit him for the benefits. Minor can be admitted to the partnership firm as a partner for the benefits. But don't misunderstand here. Even though law is not fixing any liability on the part of a minor partner in a partnership firm, personally, minor's capital is liable. We will discuss in detail in the Partnership Act regarding the partner's liability in a partnership firm as a partner. But as of now, whether a minor can be allowed as a partner in a partnership firm or not, we can say yes, but only for the purposes of profits. Yes, but for profits only. But for profits only. Now, minor as a member of a company. Miner as a member of a company. Now here acquisition of the shares are of three types. Acquisition of the shares are of three types. Bear in mind, a person can be a member or can acquire shares in three modes. The first one is by application to the company for allotment of shares on issue. That is the first mode of acquisition of the shares in the company. The second one, transfer of shares. The second one, transfer of shares. The third one, transmission of shares. What is the meaning of transfer of the shares? Transfer means X, a shareholder. Now he wants to transfer, he wants to dispose of his shares to Y. Y may purchase. Y may wants to transfer his shares in case of Z. He may transfer. This is the transfer. What is the meaning of the transmission? X. He is having some shares in a company. He wants to make his son as the nominee, and he placed his son as the nominee. We will discuss all these things in the Companies Act, which is a higher standard or higher stage of IPCC or CA Inter later. Now, on the occasion of death, on death of Mr. X, X shares or the shares which are registered in the name of Mr. X will be automatically transmitted or given to his son, who is the nominee. Say for example, X1 is the son of Mr. X. So on the death of Mr. X, the shares automatically will be transferred to Mr. X1, who is the nominee of Mr. X. Now he will be the shareholder. In this context, in which mode he can become as a member? The first mode is not at all possible. A miner is not eligible to make an application for the acquisition or allotment of the shares in a company because see, announcement of the shares issue in a newspaper will be termed as what we have discussed, that is nothing but invitation to offer. In case if a company announced that the company is coming to a issue, public issue, it is nothing but an invitation to offer. Making an application is nothing but offer. Allotment is nothing but acceptance, which is a contract. Hence, it is not at all possible in the case of miner. Transfer and transmission, fully paid up shares. Yes, one can transfer in favor of a miner. In case of transmission, fully paid up shares, no problem. For the fully paid up shares, miner can be a member. But in case if they are partly paid up, I will explain you later what is the meaning of fully paid up and partly paid up. For the partly paid up shares, miner is not liable.